Your Bengal Pride marching band has already brought home two grand championships so far this season. The Bengal Pride is presenting their 2023 show entitled David. Drum major senior Ben Smith, is your band ready?
Welcome, everybody. This is a great opportunity. I want to share some time with our band director, Richie Williams, coming off an eighth consecutive state championship, which is unbelievable.
Unheard of.
Unbelievable. And first of all, I appreciate Richie for taking the opportunity. I'm Jimmy Dodd Jr., voice of the Rams, and we had to sit down with Richie and talk about what is just a tremendous accomplishment for the band program. And get a little bit deeper into Richie's background and what led him to where he is today, and a little bit about the competition that I think everybody would find pretty interesting. So, first of all, thanks for taking the time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
We just got through talking about, I can remember when you were a student out here in like 1995 doing some crazy stuff in the gym during basketball season, and our good friend, the late Dr. Jay Springman, who was such a good instructor out here at Paragould for a long time. He was actually Teacher of the Year one year.
Yes.
And was a remarkable influence on a lot of people out here. But first of all, just share with everybody what led you to where you are now from when you were a student here at Paragould.
Sure. So moved to Paragould in 92 from Marion in the ninth grade, and immediately fell in love with Paragould. I mean, I remember when we got here, I told my mom, I was like, hey, I said, this is a cool place to be. And the first week of school was Greene County Tech Week. I didn't know anything about Greene County Tech, but I could tell this was a big rivalry.
Yeah.
So we went home and I made cardboard horns and stapled them to a hat and wore them to school. And just turned out, by the time I graduated, I think the nickname was Richie the Ram Man Williams. So I've been either a student, staff member with the band, or announcing basketball games, or on faculty for 31 consecutive years now here at Paragould. And it's just, it's home, and I love being here. Early on, I knew band directors what I wanted to do. I had some really good teachers from all the way back from Marion to here at Paragould to mentors around the area. And so I kind of knew in the seventh grade, man, this is what I want to do the rest of my life, is be a teacher, be a band director. Went to Arkansas State University, got my Bachelor of Arts, got out of college and actually was like I did store manager. I was a regional sales director for Dr. Pepper and kind of did the business world aspect. But something was just tugging at me saying, hey, you need to be a teacher. You've always wanted to teach.
Yeah.
So I went back and got my ed degree in 2007, got my master's in 2009, started here at Paragould in 2008. And so we've been, you know, blowing and going ever since then.
15 years.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
So I, you know, came in and at the time it was Dr. Hossman and and Brett Gibson was our principal. And I just told him, I said, well, I want to create one of the best band programs, not only in Arkansas and the Mid-South, but in the nation. And I remember they looked at me and was like, okay, well, good luck with that, you know? And so it's been an incredible journey these past 15, 16 years so far.
You know, it has. And for people around town that haven't had the opportunity to be in here, this is the first time I've come in here. This place is amazing. And the amount of hardware that's displayed up here is just incredible. And it's a wow factor. People come in here and go, wow. And that's a testament to a lot of hard work by a lot of students.
Miss Smith, our former superintendent, she said, how long are you going to be here? I said, well, Dixie graduates in 25 and Dexter graduates in 2030, so I'm going to stay here at least till then. She said, draw up something that, you know, you would never want for anything ever again. And and we drew up this Taj Mahal, if you will, and it has been a tremendous amount of space and what we're able to get done in here. It's 29,000 square feet, upstairs and downstairs, and I don't believe we will ever outgrow this building.
No, a far cry from the old building.
Oh my God, yeah, exactly. That one was maybe 9,000 square feet, so.
Unbelievable. Who were some of the, and maybe still are, the influencers musically for you?
My beginning band director, George Pokorsky at Marion, I watched this guy. He was very energetic, very charismatic. I watched him for a couple of weeks, and I remember I came home and told my mom, I said, man, this is what I want to do the rest of my life. This guy's having fun. He's teaching.
Yeah.
You know, I loved music. He loved music. I had another band director at, he was at West Memphis at the time, and then he retired from Jonesboro, Steve Warner. really taught me how to be a band director. I ended up doing my internship with him. And that's not to leave out Trey Reilly and Terry Hogarth. I mean, both mm-hmm. those guys, they were very just fun guys to be in the band with. They had a very, we did joke of the day every day. So it was yeah. kind of a different atmosphere than what I grew up with in band. When I got to college and I started teaching, I've got one I always brag on this guy. He was from Union City, Tennessee. His name's John Easley. And he saw my bands the first few years and he pulled me aside and goes, okay, you've kind of got it figured out. I'm going to give you some real good pointers to get you on the next level. And when that happened, man, this program took off.
Unbelievable. I want to ask you a little bit about the competition because, like I told you a few minutes ago, I went in and looked at, there's a scorecard that's available online. You can go look at how we ranked versus the other schools. And I didn't realize this, but they broke this down into two categories, music performance and visual.
Yep.
Explain to everybody both of those and what goes into it from your preparation.
Sure. So, and to back up to kind of talk about the state championship, we would go win grand championships. We'd go to marching contests and be the top band at that contest. Mm-hmm. No one really understood what a grand championship was. Everybody understands what a state championship is. So I made a proposal back in 2014 to start a committee to look at starting a state marching contest and was told by everybody, there's no way we'll never have one. We'll never get past. Well, in 2016, we had our first state championship. And I was on the committee that helped get basically everything started. And we decided, we're going to judge off two things, music and visual. And music and visual also have effect, which means you can have the music ensemble, which that's just how does the band sound? Visual ensemble, how's the band look? And then effect, how did that music make, how did it affect you, the judge or the audience member? Did what we do musically, did it make everything make sense? Mm-hmm. Visual effects the same way. Did what you hear, did you get to see it maybe in the flags or what the band was doing? So when you sit down to make a show, you're thinking, how can I get the highest scores out of my music? How can I get the highest score out of my visual? And so those two factors, music is still the most important.
Right.
It's 60% and visual's 40%.
Right.
But so you want to make sure your music is always the best, you know, that can be. But we always try to do shows that are very, the shows that the kids want to do, I guess. We always, right. like this year's show was David versus Goliath.
Mm-hmm.
There was a hero, there was a villain, you know, everybody can get behind, you right. know, something like that. So, as far as the preparations, we're already getting ready right now. We've already started talking about what next year's show is. We're meeting with designers who kind of, you know, I asked the guys, hey, what do y'all want to do next year? And we're already throwing show ideas out there.
When you do this, do you tailor this to what you think the judges are looking for, or do you tailor it to what we want to do and think the judges are going to like what we do, our approach?
Well, with anything, you got to figure out your strengths. And whatever your strengths are, that's what you got to play to. This year I had a real, real good virtuosic soprano saxophone player. And we basically featured him in our middle tune in our ballad. It was Hero by Mariah Carey. And the judges are just like, wow, now this is gorgeous. And so you always want to play to your strengths and try to hide your weaknesses as best you can. But there are shows that the judges really like, and there are shows that, okay, they kind of keep seeing the same thing.
Right.
You know, back in the day, people used to do rock and roll shows, you know, music of the 60s or 70s.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can't really do those shows anymore because marching band has turned into theater on the field.
Yeah.
You're basically, you know, telling a story, not only through the music, but through all the, you know, the production with the what you're doing with your body and what the color guard does and how they dress up. And even the band now, we don't even wear the traditional uniforms anymore. We wear them for home games, but, you know, we'll dress up in character, whatever the show is.
Yeah. Yeah, a performance on the field. I mean, it's like you're going to the theater almost.
Yes, correct.
How much work goes in from the students? Because first of all, in order to get a high level of score on music performance, the kids have got to be good on instruments.
Yeah.
And how do you get the kids good on instruments? How do they improve? How do you work with them? And I'm assuming you do that individually to get them better.
The most important time in marching season is what we do in concert season, what we call sit-down band. You know, right now, as soon as marching season's over, we start working on all-region music. It was like we're working up how well can they play things technically, how well can they get their tone to sound. So we spend all this time from, you know, November until about March, and that's all we're doing is just making them better players in here.
Mm-hmm.
When we get done with spring break, we start what's called spring training, and that's where we're 2 days a week. We're teaching them how to move their feet, mm-hmm. how to make their bodies look, and then how to play at the same time.
Right.
And so hopefully by the end of May, we've got a really good grasp on how we're going to be for the spring or for the summer when we show back up in July. And when we show back up in July, that's if you kind of put in terms of football, it's that's 2-a-days. That's we start at 7,
right.
Go to 11, come back at 12, and go to 4. And we do that 5 days a week, and then we'll do some Saturdays and just put in a tremendous amount of hours to perfect the show.
It's amazing because you think about that. It's one thing to be able to play the instrument. It's another thing to be able to play the instrument precisely when you're doing all the other movements.
Yeah.
And I mean, practice.
Yes. We are believe in reps and more reps. You know, yeah. I never tell the kids practice at home because we're here so much. I say, hey, go do your homework. Go live your life. Go if you can get a job. You know, the days are off. We're going to do the work here, you know, in band time.
It's amazing because, and this is the next question, you've established such a level of competency and accomplishment here. It's one thing to get there. It's another thing to stay there.
Yeah.
And because you, first of all, I think that this would be a fair statement. The success that you've had with our band here has made the bands in our area better.
Oh, tremendous! Yes,
because we've got it. You know, look what they've accomplished. And it's you know whether it's locally or even statewide. And I assume you see that.
Yes, when we started this journey, you know, 15, 16 years ago, you know, all I had to do was you know do some extra practices and put a little extra time in, and we were going to be good because no one else was really had their eyes on marching band. It was kind of the bad, you know, everyone thought concert band was where it needs to be, but I told everybody, I said, you know, the marching band is what everyone sees. That's what everybody, you know, wants to enjoy. So we got that marching band good. Man, everybody else started going, oh man, they're pretty good. We need to change the game. And really change the landscape of the entire state. Of how people view marching band and how they practice, how they prepare. So it definitely changed everything when they kind of saw us building and having more and more success. This year's band to me, my two most prized state championships. The first one, obviously, because you know they said we would never have it. This one right here was probably the hardest we've worked for a state championship. I don't know if you've noticed, but our numbers were way down this year.
I was fixing to make a comment about that.
Yeah. Our numbers are way down because this is the last year of our COVID hangover. Our seniors this year, they were in eighth grade, and so they didn't get that spring training because COVID happened, world shut down. I had 65 in that band. I'm only graduating 11 seniors.
Wow.
So I had like 50-some kids that should be here with us.
Yeah.
They quit, so our numbers are about 85 this year. Now, we're only graduating 11, and my eighth grade band this year has got about 60-plus in it, so our numbers should jump way back up to where we've been in the past.
When we do halftime, and we take a little break during halftime to go get refreshed and something to drink and all that. But I listen to what's going on out there. And I could tell a noticeable difference between week one and the week before you went to competition.
Yeah.
And you could tell these guys have stepped it up. You can, I mean, the precision was there, the sharpness, all of it. And you could tell that they had their game face on.
Yeah.
They were ready. And I'm assuming that you build toward that.
Oh, yeah. We preached the whole year. The kids knew, like, hey, we're smarter this year. Our back's against the wall. Everybody knows we're vulnerable. If we're going to go get a state championship this year, man, we're really going to have to work for it. I'm not saying we didn't work for it in the past,
right. But
it's easier to hide things when you've got 140, 150, 60 kids on the field as opposed to 85.
Yeah.
everybody, our individual scores, that's where you have like a judge on the field who's listening and who's watching. Our individual scores were tremendously high because they were like, man, every kid is contributing on this field.
Right.
No one was hiding.
Right. Well, that's what I mean. It's not just one or two kids that are good on instruments. You've got a whole bunch of them.
Yeah.
And the practice that's required, and it's whether it be in football, basketball, or whatever, is there's a lot of dedication and a lot of time and effort and probably trial and error to get the kids where you want them.
Yeah.
And
the cool thing about band that I think is always a good selling point for us, there's no bench in band. Everybody plays all the time. It's just up to us to find what role they can fill so that the whole can be successful. And so, you know, we've got some plans for the off season, trying to really tap into a lot of kids on our campus who aren't involved in anything. They're not doing ROTC, athletics, theater, band. They're not doing anything. So we're trying to tap into some of them to get them to get involved. Hey, come alongside and maybe this is a place for you.
You know, you've got, you just accomplished this recently. Kind of let everybody know what you've got going the rest of the year in terms of competition. So between now and the time school's out in May.
Sure. Right now, this is kind of a slower time for us, as you can imagine, after you're done with four straight hard months of marching band. We're basically getting ready for all region auditions, which are coming up, Jazz All Region. We'll put on a Christmas concert, march in the Christmas parade next month. The next semester, we get ready for, there's now concert band state championships that just started a couple years ago. We haven't won it yet. We've been close. So that's kind of our next goal. Mm-hmm. That happens the week before spring break. So basically January, February, half of March, that's what our next focus is going to be on. Our indoor percussion group, it's as you can imagine, it's our percussion. They march a mini show inside of a gym. We've won our class in the state championship for that several years in a row now, and that's part of what we're getting ready for on the side, getting ready for that indoor percussion group. And then, like I said, as soon as spring break's over, it's spring training, and it's all about getting ready for marching season and getting the kids all fired up and getting them ready to move.
You know, you've created really an amazing legacy here, and also from the accomplishments. The question I've got for you is, what are your goals from here? What do you want to do with the band program, let's just say in the next 5 years?
Sure.
You know, how do you take it, if there is a next level, how do you take it there?
Well, my first main priority is getting us back to where we were. And as far as numbers go, I mean, we're mm-hmm. still having the success that you know we've had, but it's getting our numbers back up and getting us back to national competitions. So we're not where we need to be at size-wise. Some of these larger competitions turns into how many kids you got on the field, how much color guard you've got. So that's my 5-year goal is to get us back to Indianapolis, to the Bands of America Grand Nationals. We've been there before, we've mm-hmm. done well. So we want to get back there. Next year is looking like a trip year. We are pushing heavy to march in the inauguration parade in 2025.
Wow. Yeah.
So that process is a year long, applying, getting information to senators, governors, you know, to have us hopefully be selected.
Yeah.
And if that doesn't happen, the bad thing is that you don't know you get selected until after the election in November. So we've got
to leave a lot of prep time.
We're planning on that's going to be our goal. If we can get there, if not, we'll take a spring trip, maybe over spring break, and do like Orlando or do something fun like that. But for us, I mean, keep the ball rolling. I mean, keep the state championships coming. They're getting harder to come by every year. My good friends at Greene County Tech, I'm really good friends with their directors. I know there's a rivalry there, you know,
sure.
with everything. But we're really, really good friends. They're coming back to Class 5A next year, as you know.
Right, yep.
So they were right there with us at competitions, right nipping at our heels.
Yep.
And so, we got to do everything that we can to make sure that we stay just above the curve.
Right, right. So you've got an idea already of what you want the performance next year to look like.
Sure.
That's amazing.
Now, we won't announce it until March.
But, like, you've got the music sort of picked out. You've got the background and the theater portion of it.
This is, you know, these are some of these are our strong sections. These are things that we probably want to feature. And we're already kind of thinking about what competitions we'd want to go to that kind of, you know, keep the season where you just keep building, where obviously the pinnacle is going to be going back to state at War Memorial.
But what's fascinating is what you said. So you know your kids that are going to be a year older next year, but you know their strengths. In other words, if you've got, just as in layman terms, if you've got a bunch of great trumpet players, we want to feature that, and that will figure into our plans on what we're going to showcase.
Exactly. And it just makes sense. Whatever you're strong at, man, you want to make sure that's out there, and the judge is like, okay, giving you points, and just hide as best you can things that maybe aren't as good. They're not bad by no means, but just not as strong as your really strong stuff.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, first of all, thanks for doing this, because I mean, it's a fascinating inside look to what goes on behind the scenes, and just to come into this building and to kind of stop for a second and think about all the kids that have participated over the 15 years that you've been here. That's an awful lot of kids.
Yeah.
The kids that are still in the school system that are going to move through. And you got to be proud of those accomplishments.
Oh my gosh. I mean, when we look back, we've won 53 grand championships in that amount of time. That's about 3 or 4 grand championships a year. Just to do something like that is pretty tremendous. I mean, you can imagine. When I sat and said what I wanted to do when I first started and where we're at today, I still have to kind of take a step back and go, man, We've done a lot. We've had great kids, great boosters, unbelievable support from administrators, from central office, school board members. I mean, it's been a total effort from everybody to really believe in a goal.
Yeah.
And the goal was to create one of the best band programs in America. And, you know, the National Band Association has named us one of the top eight in the nation before. The National Association of Music Merchants puts us as one of the top 400 school districts for music education every year. So it's, we've definitely set the goal, and we're definitely accomplishing
it. It's awesome, and it takes leadership, and it takes execution on your part and the kids' part, and it's amazing to watch it come together at a critical moment like that competition. So, man, what a great job. I mean, I don't know how to compliment you more than that. I mean, it's been a great ambassador for the school and for the city.
Yes.
And I mean, you guys have just done such a great job. So, one other thing, during basketball season, you've got the playlist during the games. I want one night, we're going to bring Sugarloaf back from the 70s.
Okay.
Don't call us, we'll call you.
Okay.
And a few things like that. I've been on Zach for that. I said, I want one night, I want to put my playlist together, and we're going to.
It's going to be throwback night
at the dock.
I love it. So I love it.
It's going to be awesome. Richie, thanks for the time. This has been awesome. I hope everybody enjoyed this. And again, congratulations to you and the students on just an unbelievable accomplishment. 8 straight years, and let's go get 8 more.
Dude, I'm for it.
I appreciate it. Thanks so Richie much. Williams. Hope everybody enjoyed it. Take care, everybody in the Ram Nation.